In this video, I'll show you how to open a Win32 window in C and respond to the X button to close. This tutorial is split into this video, which will go over the code in the detail required for a good understanding, and a text version in a deep dive format, which will explore the code in greater detail. The code is available at the top of the text version of this tutorial, linked below. Everything we need is in windows.h. I've also included standard bool for the true and false macros. Win32 defines its own main function entry point, and handles some behind-the-scenes Windows setup, then calls winmain, which we can treat as the new entry point for our program. We create a window class to hold information about the window. The name is used to reference our class later. LePiffinWindProc is appointed to a function Windows will call in order to handle events, or as Windows calls them, messages. We register the class with Windows, then create a window based on it. The name from before identifies our window class. Here we can give our window a title and tell Windows what kind of window to create with a window style. WS overlapped window combines the usual border, title bar, and so on, while WS popup creates a borderless window. The next four arguments are the X and Y coordinates of the top left of our window, then the width and height. With an overlapped window, you can let Windows decide these values with CW use default. But with a pop-up window, you must define these values. We check the function was successful, then continue. Show window makes our window finally appear. NCMD show tells Windows whether our program was launched with some specific settings such as maximized or minimized, which could be set through a program shortcut. If you wish to ignore those settings, you can OR in WS visible along with the window style in create window and skip the show window function. We have a global Boolean variable we can use to exit our main program loop, then some message processing code. Check for the next message and remove it from the queue. Translate message takes virtual keystrokes and adds applicable character messages to the message queue. You can skip that function if you're only going to handle virtual keys instead of characters. Dispatch message passes the message over to our window class function pointer, LePiffinWindProc, and we find ourselves inside the window process message function. We switch on the message. If it's a quit or destroy message, we set our quit variable to true so that our program will exit. Otherwise, we pass the message on to Windows' default window procedure. To compile, we need to link to user32.lib, which contains implementations for the Win32 functions in the code. With this code, our program window will stay open and responsive until we hit the X button, Alt+F4, or End Task from Task Manager, at which point it will gracefully close. That's how to open a window with the Windows native library in C. If you want a more in-depth look at the code, including explanations of all the function arguments and a look at some alternative lines of code, the deep dive version of this tutorial is linked below. If you have any feedback on the code or extra information I could add to the deep dive, please leave it below. Also, tell me what you think of this tutorial format, and I'll strive to keep improving as I make more. In my next tutorials, I'll show you how to draw pixels to the window using a backbuffer and handle keyboard and mouse input. Cheers!